Grade 10, Unit 15, Hydrostatic Pressure and its Application. First, we discuss about the solid pressure. The definition of solid pressure is, pressure is the force acting on an unit surface area. So, this is the equation for solid pressure. Perpendicular force, F, divided by surface area. So you can see here the area under the box is surface area is A and applied force is F. So you can easily calculate the solid pressure by F divided by surface area. That's mean F divided by A. So unit of this pressure is Newton per square meter, or we can view it is as a Pascal. So how we get this SI unit? First, you can write down the equation. Pressure means force divided by surface area. For that equation, you can apply the SI unit. For the force, SI unit is Newton. Surface area, the SI unit is square meters. By dividing Newton by square meters, you can get Newton per square meter. That's the pressure for the unit for the pressure. So 1 Newton per square meter, we can equal to 1 Pascal. So you can use both the units for the pressure. That's mean Newton per square meter or Pascal. Then we can do some several calculation using this solid pressure equation. Question number one. Here you are given a box. Area under the box is 0.4 square meters. Then weight of the box also given 800 newton. So the data relevant to this question is surface area is 0.4 square meters and weight of this box, this means force is 800 newton. You have to calculate the pressure created by this box on this table, right? So first you have to write the solid pressure equation. This means pressure equal to force divided by surface area. Then you can apply values to this equation with their relevant SI unit. Then force is 800 newton divided by surface area is 0.4 square meters. Then you can get the answer 2000 newton per square meter, or you can say 2000 Pascal. Let's do another question. So here the dimension of the box is given in centimeters and the mass of the box is given in kilograms. So you have to calculate the pressure exerted by this box on this table. This same question we discussed in the first one, but only difference is the dimension given in centimeters and also the mass. Here mass is given, not the weight. But in you know this pressure equation, always we need force, not the mass. Then in this equation, the mass is given 400 kilogram. First, we have to convert this mass into force. How you convert the mass into force? That means weight, using Newton's second law. That means F equal ma. If you use the F equal ma, you can convert the mass into the force. So we can calculate the force like this. Force means mass into gravitational acceleration. So mass is here 400 kilogram. It is multiplied by 10. That's mean gravitational acceleration. Then you can get the weight of this box is 4000 newton. Then area under the box is also you have to calculate. It is here dimension given in centimeters. You have to convert into meters. Then area under the box is 5 meters into 2 meters, that's mean 10 square meters. After that, you can write the relevant equation for the pressure. This means solid pressure is force divided by surface area. Here force is 4000 Newton. The surface area is 10 square meters. Then you can get the answer is 400 Newton per square meter or 4000 Pascal. 400 Pascal. Then question number 3. Here the question is the pressure exerted by the pile of soil disturbed over area is 0.4 square meters. The pressure exerted on the ground is 800 Pascal. Then you want to calculate the force created by this pile driver. So this is the pile driver. It is used to dig the soil. Area of the pile driver is given 0.4 square meters. Then also it is mentioned the pressure created by this pile driver. You want to calculate the force. Then these are the data given. It is better to write down the data like this. Then it is easy to calculation. So area is 0.4 square meters. Pressure is 800 Pascal or 800 Newton per square meters. Then pressure is force divided by surface area. That the solid pressure equation. Using that equation, you can easily take the force. Force means pressure into surface area. So here pressure is 800 Newton per square meters, and the area is 0.4 square meters. So you can calculate the pressure is 320 Newton. These are some calculation based on the solid pressure. So one equation we already discussed, that means solid pressure is pressure equal to force divided by surface area. Then we move to the liquid pressure. So liquid pressure is called hydrostatic pressure because the common liquid used for our day-to-day application is water. So that is why it is called hydrostatic pressure. So pressure created by any liquid is called hydrostatic pressure. There are some characters of the hydrostatic pressure. Our first character is liquid pressure acts on every direction. Solid pressure, not like that. Solid pressure directly applying downwards. But liquid pressure can apply all directions. So you can show, you can easily demonstrate this by consider polythene bag. You can add, fill that in liquid and make several holes like this. Then you can see water eject in different directions. Using that, we can show the liquid pressure created in every direction. Then second feature of the liquid pressure is same level, liquid pressure same. You can easily demonstrate that. You can take a plastic bottle and same level, you can make several holes. And pour the liquid into this plastic bottle, you can see water eject distance is same. If you measure the distance from this bottle to the ejection point, the all are same. This means same level, liquid pressure, same. Then another feature of the liquid pressure is when you go down the liquid pressure increase. You can easily show this one. Take a plastic bottle and make several holes in different length, different depth. And pour the liquid into this bottle, you can see the holes in the bottom of this bottle, the water eject more distance than the hole in the upper level. Then other thing is, liquid pressure not depend on the shape of the liquid or amount of the liquid it contains. Consider you have five different shape vessel and fill that vessel in the liquid, that is the vertical height is same. And when you measure the each vessel at the bottom, you can see the pressure is same. So this is the experiment. We can do that. You can take the three different shape vessel and pour the liquid. Vertical height of the each liquid is same. And when you measure the pressure at the bottom of each liquid, you can see the pressure is same. So using that, we can prove that the liquid pressure only depend on the vertical height of the liquid. It not depend on the shape of the liquid or amount of the liquid. So that's a simple experiment, activity 15.1. Using this experiment, we can prove that the liquid pressure not depend on the shape of the liquid or amount of the liquid it contains. So this experiment, you need the 5 different shape of vessels and PVC tube. Then you can connect this vessel like this into one PVC tube. Then you can pour the liquid for this one in the same height. And you can observe here there are 5 point Q, R, S, T, and U. When you measure the pressure of this each point, you can see the pressure of the each point all are same, because height of the liquid column in every vessel, height is H. So you can fill this table. That means each tube A, B, C, D, and E, the vertical height is H. So when the vertical height is equal, you can see the bottom of the each vessel, the Q, R, S, T, and U, the pressure are same. So what the final conclusion of this experiment is, the liquid pressure only depend on vertical height of the liquid, the H. It is not depend on the shape of the liquid or amount of the liquid. Consider in this liquid, in this vessel contain more liquid when compared to this, but both the vessel at the bottom, the liquid pressure same.